Hello everyone, welcome back to Skyrim. You join me here just as I have trained 5 times in archery before we get that inevitable level up. Now, I may actually have increased my skills so many times before leveling up this time that if I level up now, I will level up twice. And that will be... that will mean that we've wasted 5 potential training sessions. Not too bothered about that, really, but... Okay, no, we're cool. So if we train again... Bang, 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 bang. Yeah, okay, so we've leveled up again. My gold is rapidly diminishing, but that's okay. I'm happy to spend basically all of it on training at this point, seeing as how we... seeing as how we seem to be finding everything else that we want, you know, in the meantime. So, now we have all our base stats. Magicka, health and stamina are at 150, which is awesome. We've got 2 perks to pick, and we're going to train again. What are we on? 444, yeah, so it's going to be expensive, but... Okay, so we've only got 4,300 gold left. But we are now... Yeah, we're halfway to another level up again. Cool, thanks Niruin. Oh, I will my friend. I will also grab all of your steel arrows which you keep providing me with. This should compensate for the arrows that we used to kill all those skeevers. Such a stupid exploit. I think it was in Oblivion as well. People were just constantly, they just have an infinite supply. So as long as I'm prepared to stand here and keep picking up these arrows. Yeah, 120, that'll do it. Anyway, we need to talk to Mercer Frey.
If you need marksman training, and you've
got the tool, there you are. I've consulted my contacts regarding the information you recovered from Golden Glow Estate, but no one can identify that symbol.
I found the same marking at Honningbrew Meadery.
It would seem our adversary is attempting to take us apart indirectly by angering Maven Blackbriar. Very clever.
Maybe we should recruit them.
You jest, but they've been able to avoid identification for years. They're obviously well-funded, driven, and patient. Just don't mistake my admiration for complacency. Our nemesis is going to pay dearly.
How can we make them pay?
Because even after all their posturing and planning, they've made a mistake. The parchment you recovered mentions a Godgil lie. According to my sources, that's an old alias used by one of our contacts. His real name is Gollum Eye.
Where do I begin?
Gollum Eye is our inside man at the East Empire Company in Solitude. I'm betting he acted as a go-between for the sale of Golden Glow Estate and that he can finger our buyer. Get out there, shake him down, see what you come up with. Talk to Brynjolf before you leave if you have any questions.
When he said finger our buyer, yeah. In case you aren't from the UK, fingering in the UK means, like, sticking your fingers into a sexual place of someone, be they a man or a woman, but usually it's implied with, you stick your fingers into someone's orifice, that's fingering them.
I can't believe Gollum Eye's mixed up in all this. That Argonian couldn't find his tail with both hands. Don't get me wrong. He could scam a beggar out of his last septim, but he's no mastermind.
Think he'll give me trouble?
Trouble? Huh. He's one of the most stubborn lizards I've ever met. You have your work cut out for you.
So how do I get him to talk?
You're going to have to buy him off. It's the only way to get his attention. If that fails, follow him and see what he's up to. If I know Gollum Eye, he's in way over his head. And you'll be able to use it as leverage.
Betrayal or not, I will let him live.
I'm glad to see you're embracing our methods. It would be a waste to lose a contact at the East Empire Company before we had the entire story. Just keep on Gullamai's tail, and he's bound to step into something he can't scrape off his boot.
How is Gullamai an asset to the guild?
Gullamai works in the East Empire Company warehouse. He helps maintain all of the shipments of goods that goes in and out of Solitude. That means he has the pick of the litter from some of the finest goods to grace Skyrim's shores. He isn't exactly in the guild, but he pays us a cut of all the stuff he lifts from the warehouse.
Interesting, right, enough.
Good luck in Solitude. Keep Gullamai alive, but remind him who we are.
Can do, sir, can do. Once again, we don't have the speech training. It was a bit cheap. I probably shouldn't actually have done all of the...
What did you need?
All of the, like, archery training. Speech training would probably have been a better option, considering that it takes a lot longer to increase your speech stats than it does your archery stats, which we would have done natively just by using a bow and arrow a lot. However, from now on, I will start speech training, and then that'll be okay. Ratway Falls, no. Where's Tanila? Just before we go, we need to sell off some of our stolen crap. We're carrying quite a bit, I think. Let's see. Just very quickly go through all this boiled cream treat, all this random shite that I picked up in Honningbrew. It's not in any way useful, so things like drums, boots and clothing just takes up carry space that we need to have available to us. Flagon. Available to us for all going forward. You know, all larceny going forward. Goblets, grilled leeks. Oh, I love leeks. If you watch my Arx Fatalis series, you'll know I love leeks. Hat. All, like, notes and books and diaries I'm keeping because I'm going to store them all in my house at Lakeview Manor. 32 of those. Nice. Horsehide. Light boots. Iron stuff. Jugs. Lavender. Very quickly just go through. Oh, that's what we got from Maven Blackbriar as our reward. Looks pretty nice. We'll use that as our one-handed weapon if we need one. Plates, pots, all random crockeries, all useless pieces of shit. Red apple, roll of paper, salmon steak, salt pile, silver ingots. Oh, they're quite valuable and heavy. Silver necklace. Skeever tail, 18 of those, that's nice. Spigot, sweet roll, tankards, the Wabjack book, wine, and 5 wooden plates. That will do. What have we got? 127 burden. Fine, that's fine. Let's move. Let's get on with this. We're wasting time here. Nearly 10 minutes in already. We need to make our way to Solitude. We can get there by carriage. Not been there before as this character, so...
What did you need?
When you enter a city for the first time, you will see a small cutscene. Not a cutscene, but like a small dramatic encounter which only plays once. In Solitude, it's someone being publicly executed as part of the Civil War, I believe, or some sort of political misunderstanding. So we will watch that happen as well, as it's quite quick. This is not the exit. Oh, that's weird. Boarded off. I was going to say, the exit on this side is not the one to Riften Stables. But we will... So we'll just go quickly across this way, where we know we can get a carriage from. And then we'll be... quickly in Solitude and ready to begin. Out here. Throat of the World, exclusive blade greybeards. Yeah, we're not going to be going up the throat of the world during this series, but we may do in the future if I decide to do the main quest, which I probably will. Just can't guarantee when. Hey, bud.
Need a ride?
Yep.
Where do you want to go?
Solitude, please.
Climb and back, and we'll be off. First time to Solitude? Beautiful old city. Capital of Skyrim, but I'm sure you already...
Yep, so Solitude is the capital of Skyrim. Since the... You know, since Tamriel is like an empire. But it wasn't always that way. The old capital is Windhelm. Another place that we haven't been to yet. Windhelm is also the oldest city in Skyrim. And one of the coolest looking... I can't wait till we do inevitably go there. But Solitude is an amazing looking city. Probably the most impressive looking in the whole game. I will just quickly pop down here so we can see the context. You see down here is this harbour with these ships. Then this huge arch. The city of Solitude is on top of this natural rocky outcrop which goes underneath out to the ocean, and if we look on the map here, you can see we're at the top edge of Skyrim here, and this is the open ocean to the northeast of here. Around this sort of place is Solstheim, where we can go in Morrowind's Blood Moon expansion and in this game's Dragonborn expansion, which is basically a small island halfway in between Skyrim and Morrowind. So it's all very interesting stuff lore-wise, but this is a very cool city nonetheless. And what time of day are we on? 2:40 a.m. May actually wait a few hours just so we get some daylight. Of course, you get this Aurora Borealis effect sometimes at night in Skyrim, which is cool. But it's just nice to be, seeing as how we don't need to be sneaking around yet, nice to be... doing this stuff in daylight, so I'll wait like just 5 hours, I guess. There we go. Just so we have a bit of daylight to light things up. Looks a bit better. Here's another Khajiit caravan you can see here. The one I mentioned in the previous episode, there are several that go between cities. That's the one that goes from Solitude to, I believe, Dawnstar, I think? Dawnstar or Winterhold? Possibly Windhelm, one of the northern cities, anyway. So if we go in here, then we will see a short cutscene. Nothing to do with our business here, but still worth watching.
They can't hurt Uncle Rogvir. Tell them he didn't do it.
Positions.
Svarr, you need to go home. Go home and stay there until your mother comes.
You betrayed us!
Get on with it!
You should tell her that her uncle is stuck.
Traitor!
Betrayed his high king. Best she know now, Advar.
You're all heart, Vivian.
Rogvir, you helped Ulfric Stormcloak escape the city after he murdered High King Torig. By opening that gate for Ulfric, you betrayed the people of Solitude.
He doesn't deserve to speak!
There was no murder. Ulfric challenged Thorin. He beat the High King in fair combat. Such is our way. Such is the ancient custom of Skyrim and all Nords.
Boo! Boo!
On this day, I go to Sovngarde.
Some gate guard you were.
Okay, I think these people have seen enough, so that means I have too. But we're going to go and take a closer look at the deceased. See if he's got anything we can have. Amulet of Talos. As he's dead, this doesn't count as stealing. Time between shouts is reduced 20%. I'm going to take it, not that we have dragon shouts.
Out with it.
Can also leck with his head, which is funny. Like this. Whoop. Nice. Okay. So as you can see, Solitude is a very, very, very pretty looking town. One of my favourites in the game. Maybe my favourite in the game, actually. I do really like... Reminds me of the cities from Oblivion, like Chadenhall, Coral, Leowyn, that sort of thing. This pub is called the Winking Skeever. That's where we need to meet our contact.
If you need a place to sleep, head over to the Winking Skeever. We keep a fine inn.
Yeah, you mean this place here that I'm like 1 foot away from? Thanks for the tip. Jesus Christ. I mean, you know, by Azura, by Azura, by Azura, not Jesus Christ. Okay, here's our man.
So, what do we have here? Let me guess. By your scent, I'd say you were from the guild. But that can't be true, because I told Mercer I wouldn't deal with them anymore.
I'm here about Golden Glow Estate.
I don't deal in land or property. Now, if you're looking for goods, you've come to the right person.
You can drop the act now, Gajal Lai.
Oh, wait. Did you say Golden Glow Estate? My apologies. I'm sorry to say I know very little about that bee farm, was it?
You acted as a broker for its new owner.
Maybe I did, maybe I didn't. I can't be expected to remember every deal I handle.
Right, so we can persuade or intimidate. Once again, we don't have nearly the required speechcraft skills or perks to do that, so we can try bribing him, see what he wants. What would it take to identify the buyer?
Well, now that you mention it, there is something I've been trying to get my hands on. I have a buyer looking for a case of Firebrand wine. There just so happens to be a single case in the Blue Palace. Bring it to me, and we'll talk about Golden Glow Estate.
Okay, so we have a little, The Dragonborn's come, yes. Yes, indeed. But I don't know it yet. So, luckily, we've got a little side mission here. Luckily for us, the Blue Palace is in Solitude. Just over the other side.
Might want to rethink that. You're missing out on some wonderful opportunities.
Interesting. This is a really cool place. There's some stuff, very nice stuff in this town that we will want to be coming back to later on. The largest property that you can buy and own in the game without Hearthfire, without building your own house from the Hearthfire expansion, is Proudspire Manor, which is not this one. Possibly this one here, I think it is, and it's like a mansion house. This building here is the Bard's College, which has a mini quest line associated with it as well. That's a very cool one that I will be doing, but not in this series. If I do a series about maybe about like side quests or just random mercenary work, then that's when I would do the Bard's College, but we'll have to see what happens about that in the future. This is the Blue Palace here. You can tell by the blue rooftops and the fact that it just said Blue Palace on the screen. So we may need to do some sneaking. Like you, and I took an arrow in the knee. You're falling into your own stereotype there, my friend. So this building is like the governmental capital of, like, the sort of head office of the Empire's thing, you know, in Skyrim. Yoink. But we don't have any more business here at the moment other than to get that Firebrand wine. which was not exactly well hidden, because there is a very, very cool quest, not related to the Thieves Guild, but to another faction, that does include the Blue Palace kitchens. And I hope we will get to that in the future, because goddamn, that one's awesome. That one really is awesome. If we just hurry up way back to Gulamai, the Winking Skeever, harvesting. Hello.
Hey, wanna play tag?
Nope.
Papa says I won't see Rogvir anymore.
We'll go back to Winking Skeever, we will give him his wine, and we will get our information. Hello.
Ah, I see you have the wine. Hand it over, and we'll talk.
I have the Firebrand wine.
Good. Can't have the buyer getting impatient and looking elsewhere for this, can we? Here, take this. I certainly can't use it, but I suppose I need to pay you something for the goods.
You're trying to bribe me now?
Not at all. I consider it an investment in prolonging my life. As far as Golden Glow Estate goes, I'll tell you what I know. I was approached by a woman who wanted me to act as the broker for something big. She flashed a bag of gold in my face and said all I had to do was pay Arengoth for the estate. I brought in the coin and walked away with her copy of the deed.
Did she say why she was doing this?
Not at all. I tend not to ask too many questions when I'm on the job. I'm sure you understand. However, I did notice she was quite angry, and it was being directed at Mercer Frey.
That's it? No name or anything?
In this business, we rarely deal in names. Our identity comes from how much coin we carry.
I think you're lying to me.
Look, that's all I know. I never promised you I'd have all the answers. Now, since our transaction is done, I'll be on my way.
Shadow Gulamai. So, yeah, now we have one of those things in video games. These classic things where you have to follow someone at a safe distance and see where they end up. And one of the worst, of course, and most infamous for doing this type of thing is the GTA games.
Let me guess.
Of course, there are things in the GTA games, like from GTA 3 onwards, even to the very modern ones. You have the thing where it's like, follow this guy's car and keep him just on the edge of sight, but don't get too far away or too close, or else you fail. And those things really, really, really irritate me. This guy is fairly paranoid, so every so often he will stop and look behind him. So it's good that we keep him at a fair distance. And where he leads us, I remember being quite a difficult place to get around. So if we get to a situation which demands it, I may have to kill some people. If we aggro them, we will find out what happens about that as we get there. This is also another one of those classic things where it's like, follow this person who walks amazingly slowly, and they walk a ridiculously long distance to where they're going to, and you have to walk at the same speed, and you can't speed things up, because when they get a certain distance away, they will stop. Probably. Normally that's the way it goes in these kind of things. They stop and wait for you to get within distance of them before they carry on so that you don't lose track of them. I do remember that in this mission, actually, if you kill Gulamai, you can take a note from his body, and then you get an additional like quest objective, which is to kind of find an alternative source of information type of thing. Get out of the way, kid. Something's detecting me here, and there we go. Wondering what it was, if there was a guard walking behind me, maybe. Well, there is, actually, yeah, but I've not done anything wrong yet. As long as this guy doesn't see me, then that's fine. If he does see you, then he just tells you to stop following him. So, you can see, that was where we were. There's the Blue Palace. This is Solitude Docks. You can see geographically why it's such a... why it's taking him such a long time to get to where he's going to. But just because you have to walk down from the top of this cliff and then underneath it into this place over here. And where he's taking us is the East Empire Company's goods warehouse for Skyrim, which happens to be based under Solitude. The East Empire Company is the Imperial Provincial Trading Company. You are in an extremely unfortunate position where you are going to see me, Deja. What do you got? I could just quickly save it. Take some of your stuff. Yeah, that's fine.
It will keep its hands to itself, yes?
It will keep its hands to itself, yes? Yes, of course it will. Don't you worry about that. So he's going in here. This is a fairly large area which is full of East Empire Company guards. What are you doing? He's looking around. He's fine. He's gone in. Okay. Inside here is... there are some difficult things. We need to hide behind certain, say, like, bits of shelving and that kind of thing so that we can remain unseen by him. When he gets through here to a certain point, he goes into a secret area. We need to stay close to him because that area is ridiculously difficult to find without him showing us where it is. So, I am going to be dropping some fairly regular quick saves here. Because, every so often he will stop and look behind him. And that will ruin everything. And there are also patrolling guards. And a goat which just scared the crap out of me. Why is there a goat walking around in here? We can get on top of these shelves and stuff. Because he never leaves... he always stays on the ground. We... with a bit of clever jumping and stuff, can get on top of them. Oh, shitting crikey. The torch sconces we can as well also take. Yeah, this is probably what we should have done before. Get on top. This helps us to avoid the guards and to avoid being seen by Gulamai when he turns round. So I'm going to be trying to stick to high ground from now on.
What was that?
Oh shit.
No,
you were just hearing things. Anyone up here? Probably yes. Okay, he's down there. We stalk him along here. Again, if there are torch sconces, and that means we can take them to reduce the amount of cast light. And can I jump on that? Can I jump around? Yes, I can. Can I get out of my seat and jump around? Yeah. He's getting tetchy. Take the torch. Take it. No. Can't get that one. Shit, there's a guard coming. Okay, any way I can get higher up? What happened to that mercenary guard? He's around there, that's fine. Just stay calm. Oh shit, someone's coming. Shit. other problem with this is that somewhere in this warehouse is the item that we need to get for Delvin, the unique item, and I can't remember where it is. I just remember that it's in this place. I remember what it is, I just don't remember where. And so once our business with this guy's concluded, we may have to do a bit more exploring and possibly some killing in order to find it. Because it's probably going to be off the beaten track a little. What's up here? Ooh, novice chest. Yep, yeah, fine, I'll take it. Oh shit. Shitting shit. You just move that way. That's fine. Oh shit. Okay. He went up there and then he turned around and came back again. This is where he goes to the secret place. And this is why you need to be close to him at this point. Because it's difficult to find it otherwise. Hopefully we don't make too much noise in the water. Okay. All good. Nice. Brine Water Grotto. Cool. So, this is just like a little extra cave that we need to get through and then confront him at once we're at the end. But like I say, we do need to get the I'll just activate that. We do need to get the item for Delvin, which is somewhere in that warehouse. Now, yeah, as you can see, there are bandits here. And they don't count towards us avoiding kills. So if we get attacked by them, that's absolutely fine. We don't forfeit our bonus. Bandits are treated essentially just like any other monster in that you would find in the game, like a... What the hell? Why is there a guy swimming on the spot? What the hell is he doing? This is very unusual. But not for Skyrim. Huh? Shit. Okay, we're gonna have to kill some folks here. Well, our sneak's getting pretty good now, because he had to actually touch us to identify us. But we are now going to have a load of bandits attacking us all at once, which is not good. But still. Okay, you just stay down. Thank you. What do you got? Studded? Yeah, I'll just take all of that because you got an orcish warhammer as well. Oh god. Highwayman. That's probably even worse than a thug, isn't it? Just GTFO for now. Like I say, this has nothing to do with our bonus. It's killing these bandits is fine, so as long as we can stay alive doing it, then that's no worries. A barrel containing some honeycomb. Interesting. Okay, the bandit highwayman has lost sight of us. We are now hidden again. We may want to take these guys out anyway, just because they have loot. In fact, I haven't really got much loot so far, so why not? I really need to be taking the perk that lets you draw a bow faster. Or starting Dawnguard, which gives you crossbows. And crossbows, you fire first and then reload, rather than load and then fire. Oh shit, I'm nearly dead. I need to use potions very quickly. Healing, minor healing. All good. God, that guy's arrows are tough. What arrows does he even have? Imperial bow. Where's his body gone? It's down there somewhere. Let's find it. Those arrows did a hell of a lot of damage. Still. Doesn't really matter. Okay. Steel arrow. Take all this stuff. I'm taking whatever I can get at this point, to be quite honest. Very, very sparse on loot, this area. So, these things are like teeth on strings, and if you touch them, they rattle and let the enemies know where you are, which is kind of a neat idea, but oh shit, there's a highwayman. Shit, this is bad. This is very bad. I'm going to have to switch to melee, I think, for this. Let's try our Orcish Sword of Ice. Die. Stop blocking. Stop blocking. Stop blocking. You're down. I'm getting staggered quite heavily here. If this guy could just stop blocking, that would be terrific. Burn, you son of a bitch! Alright. Not bothered about their bodies right now, but steel mace. There's going to be some sort of bandit leader here as well, who's probably going to be really difficult to deal with. Apprentice chest. Where's the give? Okay, it's quite far to the right. Quickly running out of lockpicks here. Something like that. There we go. Steel mace, jade and sapphire. Nice, all good stuff. Yeah. That person is not going to be friendly. They're probably going to be the bandit leader. Let's see if we can take them out. Let's use Orcish arrows because we have quite a few. Highwayman. Just be careful not to hit our mark. Okay. We're sweet. Hello.
Now there's no need to do anything rash. This isn't as bad as it seems. I was gonna tell Mercer about everything, honestly. Please, he'll have me killed.
Mercer doesn't have to know.
I see you wish to be reasonable. Perhaps I misjudged you. The name of the person you want is Carlaya.
You say that name like I should know it.
Mercer never told you about her? Carlaya is the thief responsible for murdering the previous guildmaster, Gallus. Now she's after Mercer.
And you're helping her?
Help? No, no. Look, I didn't even know it was her until after she contacted me. Please, you have to believe me.
Where is Carlaya now?
I don't know. When I asked her where she was going, she just muttered, "Where the end began." Here. Take the Golden Glow estate deed as proof. And when you speak to Mercer, tell him I'm worth more to him alive.
Okay, sorted. Give me all that shit. How you doing? So, some crates here, we may as well go for them. Then we just need to find the thing for Delvin, and then we're finished. But I remember that in the warehouse there is like a some sort of an office type of thing. And it will be, and it's in there, but I just can't remember how you reach that. hopefully we'll be able to... Ooh, levers. Hopefully we'll be able to find out. Petty Soul Gem with a Petty Soul inside it. Jade and Emerald Circlet. Anything up here? Markarth Guard's Shield. Solitude Guard's Shield. 10 gold. Hey, a Dibella statue. Just like the one... Right, this is probably going to leave me out of lockpicks, but we can buy more from, I think Tanila sells them in, oh, we got it, in the Ragged Flagon. Probably not worth 18 gold for all that, still. Okay, what do these do? I have no idea. What's this? Cages. What's in the cages? Hawkers? Hawkers eat fish. It may be hawkers. This may well be a way out. Yeah, there is a hawker there. Hey, I got both my arrows back. Nice. Yeah, there are hawkers in here. I guess this is probably going to be a shortcut out, but we do need to be going back to that place, you know. Oh shit, there's one right there. Oh my god, I didn't even see that. Well hidden, sir. Well hidden indeed. Cool. So, if this takes us back out to Skyrim, that may be a problem. We may have to backtrack through the Bandit Cave. Yeah, it does. It takes us out to Skyrim. Huh. Well, I guess I could go back in through the main entrance. Let's see where this takes us. And if we can get back around to the front door, then we can try doing that. Otherwise, I'll go back in, go back through the cave. Because I do want to get all of those items. Brine Water Grotto entrance. Where are we? Yeah, we are some distance away, so... Pretty, though. Ooh, a snow fox. Don't think those guys are hostile. This is all very beautiful, as you can see. And just over there on the horizon, you can just about see, I think that's the College of Winterhold. Or possibly Dawnstar Lighthouse. Yeah, it's pretty cool though. Anyway, if we go back through this way, it's probably going to be quicker. And I'll try and do this quickly so that we can get this all tidied up and finished. Hopefully sub 1 hour. So I remember that there were a couple of bandits left alive, but they shouldn't be too hard to deal with. Or we may be able to avoid them altogether, of course. I do realise that I am not sneaking at this point, but there was the guy that we, like, wounded and then evaded. Oh dear. And a chest that I missed, apparently. Seriously running low on lockpicks here. Okay. Torches are an interesting item because they have no weight, so you might as well just keep picking them up whenever you see them, even if you would never ever want to use one in the game. Strange. There you go. Hello. A guard dog. Oh, I don't want to kill you. I like dogs. He killed a skeever as well. Oh god. Oh, it was just a bear trap. And a mace trap. So. We know there is at least one bandit still in here somewhere. Probably more than that, I can't remember exactly. And he was a tough one, like I think a highwayman. But we are coming back to the entrance here, which was just around this way, so shouldn't be too bad. Oh dear. Oh, we didn't take all your stuff, and you have a lockpick. You were also for some reason carrying a bee, which is weird. I'll take your bee, I'll take your lockpick, I'll take your everything. Right. Yeah, we snuck past these guys. That was the guy that I started on previously. Nice. Some other stuff that I missed. If I can... okay, glitching water. Strange. Huh? Not strange for Skyrim. Yeah, so sneaking didn't really work here, and that guy has a giant longsword. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. Oh dearie me. God, you are hard. Shit. Balls. Yeah, sneaking past them may be a better option, or taking them from a distance. Oh, I'm all the way back here again. God damn it. Well, I can't be asked doing the adept chests and stuff like that again. I just really want this map now and then to get the hell out of here, so. We'll just focus on doing that. I might also avoid that dog as well, because I don't really like killing dogs. Even in video games. I tell you what, let's do this again. The give point for each lock is like set at random each time you do it for the first time, sort of thing, so it's not going to be in the same place as previously. Hello. Hup. Hup. Hup.
Gonna split your belly like an old woman's purse.
This guy's really tough. And he does a lot of damage. Although he is helping me with my light armor stat. What have we got? Minor healing. I think that's all our healing now, so. Not great. We really need a healing spell, actually. That's what we need. Body's down there, but. Let's just carry on. Would be really good to not have to engage those other two who were just around here. I may go through this bit with the cobwebs to avoid them, and there's probably going to be a spider inside, but that would be way easier to deal with than two difficult bandits, I feel. Going to need to torch this, aren't we? Flames. Something's suspicious of me. Oh god, lots of things are suspicious. Yeah, they're spiders. Well, prepare to be killed. Yeah, a frostbite sword is not really much good against frostbite spiders, is it? Luckily, they aren't very difficult enemies to defeat. And they have venom, which is awesome. Okay. Burn it all down. Ah, dearie me. I just really wish I'd done this coming through the other way. Oh, shit. Right. This is going to be, hidden. So, maybe in melee I could take them. Hidden again. No, not quite. But nearly. Anybody there? I guess I okay, there we go. Give me all that. Right, so I don't know what happened to the other one because there was two before. Still, it's all right with me. I'll never do another span in that spot. Just get out of there. Just get the hell out of there. Okay. Right, now we just need to find this like head office thing. And then finally we can go. Whew, Jesus. Okay, there's a guy right there. Huh? Hmm. That looks like an office up there. And someone is... Oh, God.
I know I heard something.
Someone is... very suspicious and appears to be coming for me. Yeah, right there, in fact. Well, this is bad. Okay.
I guess I was just hearing things.
Why are there so many guards concentrated around this one area? Come on, move. I appear to be staring right at me for some reason. There we go. You pop back that way. I'm going to go up here. I think up there is where I need to be, right? It's looking promising. It would be really good if that was where I needed to be, not over the other side. This looks right. This looks right. Yeah, I think this is our place. Give me all this stuff. Boys and girls' clothes. Any skill books? No, I'll take it though. Real Baron Zaya, take it. Testaments of Dwemer Lore, Mysterious Akavir, The Talos Mistake, Ruins of Kemelzay. Wolf Pelt, lots of good stuff, well, lots of crap stuff. There it is, East Empire shipping map, fucking finally, and all this gold as well, I'm having all that. More gold. Pheasant breast. Always nice to keep a piece of pheasant breast on the floor by your bed in case you get hungry in the middle of the night. Okay, so now we just need to get out of here. It would be nice to be able to do that without killing anyone. Swimming underwater is probably going to be the best way of going about that. How did... We came in over there, didn't we, I think? Because that's where that goat is, for some reason, walking around. So if I try and swim right there, that's probably going to be a quick way out. Just so long as... Because I know there are guards around. Oh, shit. Get in the water. Fuck me. That was close. Right. Is there a ramp up here? Please be a ramp somewhere around here I can get out. There's sloping ground, which is promising. Quickly. Aha. Yes, perfect. Perfect. Just get out of there. Just help get them to leave me alone. Just leave me the fuck alone. All you mercs. Right, I think we're home and dry. Yoink. Hooray! Bloody hell. Right, so. We are now also very near to Solitude Stables, meaning we can get back to the Thieves Guild nice and quickly by carriage. And, yeah, return to Mercer Frey. So we don't need to be sneaking anymore. We aren't trespassing. This is all sweet. Hey.
Be careful.
All right. Quickly back up here. That's a very cool looking ship, isn't it? Back up here to the stables. Back to Mercer. Turn this in. Finish. It's going to be a pretty long episode. Should be a clear hour, I think. Yoink. Here he is. Here's our man.
Need a ride? Where do you want to go?
To Riften.
Climb and back and we'll be off. Oh, steady on.
Okay, we are at Riften Stables, so go to the Thieves Guild. And this time I'm going to remember to go through the graveyard rather than down to the Ratway.
You're a stranger here too, huh?
I'm not a stranger here, no. This way, I think. Yeah. Blessing of Talos, because why not? Into the Thieves Guild through the mausoleum. Down we go. Hey there.
Interest you in some marksman training?
My sister in crime. What do you need?
Wanted to say
something. Gullamai give up any information on our buyer?
He said Golden Glow was purchased by a Carlyer.
No, it can't be. I haven't heard that name in decades. This is grave news indeed. She's someone I hope to never cross paths with again.
Gullamai also told me she was a murderer.
Carlyer destroyed everything this guild stood for. She murdered my predecessor in cold blood and betrayed the guild. After we discovered what she'd done, we spent months trying to track her down, but she just vanished.
Why has she returned?
Carlyer and I were like partners. I went with her on every heist. We watched each other's backs. I know her techniques. Skills.
If she kills me, there'll be no one left that could possibly catch her. If only we knew where she was.
Gulamai told me she said, where the end began.
There's only one place that could be. The place where she murdered Gallus. A ruin called Snowvale Sanctum. We have to go out there before she disappears again.
We?
Yes, I'm going with you, and together we're going to kill her. Here's your payment for Solitude. Prepare yourself and meet me at the ruins as soon as you can. We can't let her slip through our fingers.
Sweet. So, where is the place we need to go? Oh yes, of course, we can get one of our pieces of Thieves Guild armor upgraded, but only one we have to choose. Where is this Snowvale Sanctum? Well, it doesn't matter, we'll find it next time. Okay, so I'm going to end this here. Next time we will... in fact, I'll do some preparation off camera just so... Because the next one's probably going to be a long episode. We will go to Snowvale Sanctum. We will track down Carlyle. It's going to be epic. I will see you guys then. Thank you very much for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, drop a like and I'll see you next time for more Skyrim. Take care and goodbye.